Welcome to another episode of Far Cry 4.
Hold on.
prompt, though. Assault rifle. Okay.
Let me help you.
I appreciate that, but you're just one man. The soldiers are all over the village. Do you really care?
Which means this has to be the assault rifle. Definitely moving. aiming this fucking thing at better range.
Finally.
Christ. was like, what am I supposed to do here?
Thank you.
So many months. So many, many. Charlotte. I'm not. I am here. Rakshasa is dead. Dead and gone. They're all gone. Alone, but I am here. Kalinog is dead. I have nothing. Please, I have nothing. The Thanka has all of it for me. I took it all. I don't know more than that. Poor Swaddle. Poor Thomas. I'll see you. I'm coming. Robert is coming. Thomas is mine. Tell me, Robert is coming. He will see you soon. Do not wait. I'm leaving. Sorry, sorry, sorry. I'm so sorry. I will write. Shangri-La is here. It is here. I will bring it with me for you. I'm scared, Charlotte. I need Charlotte. Please, Charlotte, for Robert. Kalinog is dead. Find me. Kirat will wait. I will wait. What a fucking mess of a letter. What a fucking mess. I feel sorry for Charlotte. I feel sorry for the kid. This guy's fucking crazy. God, this is the best thing ever. Let's just get on with the story mission.
Where is everyone?
At the Kalesh. We're getting ready for the final push. This is it. Win or lose. Sabal is splitting the Golden Path. He's jeopardizing our future, Ajay. Enough is enough.
Asking me to...
I'm telling you to kill him. I'm being very particular with my words, Ajay. Don't let him snake out of this. Besides, did you really think he was going to be okay with you betraying him and siding with me? No. We can't afford to let Sabal live. Ajay, be careful. The Golden Path needs you. I need you.
Save me, huh? All right.
Oh, Ajay, I can almost see your furrowed brow from here.
Hagen, what do you want?
Tome. I'm merely calling to check up on you. I hear your little friends are having a bit of a spat. It must be hard. What with you in the middle of it all? Choices are difficult. Trust me, I've been there. In fact, you should be grateful for the choices I've made. Choices like Yuma. I went on live television to serve her up to you, and I loathe television. Radio is so much more my thing. And you, you jumped on the opportunity. Poor Yuma. She will be missed. It was a tough call to make, picking you over her. But it was the right call. You'll see. Of course, you're in a hurry. Places to go, shit to tear up. I'll let you get back to it. But don't forget, RJ. Choices have consequences.
I'm expecting a major twist here. Because this makes no sense. Guy's a douchebag. I don't like him. I'm talking about Sabal here. But at the same time, even if he... Shit, there goes my weapons. Even if he is a religious nutcase in terms of justifying everything for whatever god, and the old thing that Sabita called Sabita. Sabalin and Mita. Oh man, Sabita, right. So I was saying that the things that Amita said in terms of child marriage and everything, and how we just didn't even say anything to defend himself, pretty much acknowledging like, yeah, well, shit, kind of like shit happens. Even so, I think it's harsh to kill him. And again, he was the guy that ultimately saved us.
She sent you, brother. Did you volunteer? What do you think you're doing? You shit on everything your father built. Congratulations. Everything that meant something is irrelevant thanks to you. That's what's truly sad, brother. You handed over everything to Amita. To Amita! You think she can fix Kirad? How? Drug fields as far as the eye can see? Suicide nets in factory towns where men, women, and children are free to be poor? It's a land of equal opportunity where everyone's a slave. Do you think this is the country your mother wanted her ashes to be scattered in? So what's it going to be, brother?
Look, dude, you're not entirely wrong, and she's not entirely right. But I'd rather have a country.
I took care of Sabal.
I can't believe it. I'm sorry, Ajay. It had to be done. That doesn't make it any easier, does it? Okay. There'll be time to deal with this later. Right now, we have a country to save.
So, I'd rather have a country where little kids, women, men are not treated differently in terms of opportunity. You know, this in terms of the child marriage and everything else, and a world where you're not forced into whatever religion it could be. And again, in terms of drug fields, all depends on how you use the drugs. And I'd rather have drug trafficking than pedophiles that use their religion to hurt and harm children. And so I still prefer Amita's ideas to Sabal's ideas. Not to mention that, judging from Mohan Gale's journal, the guy's a piece of shit, and I don't fucking like his ideals. That's not to say that Pagan Min is a good guy, because I don't think he's a good guy either, because he keeps, you know, kidnapping people, murdering people, torturing people, and everything else. So there isn't, I guess the game is realistic in that sense. There isn't anyone 100% good. But it just sucks that, you know, you have to make these decisions, but at the same time, I prefer, you know, that choices are given to me and not just a set path.
One final push. We're hitting Pagan's fortress. It won't be easy. I heard about Sabal. Whatever you're feeling, just know that Amitha only wants what's best for Kirat. We have to get going.
Okay.
Death to Pagan men!
Wait!
Way. Yeah.
Let's go, boys and girls. Jesus, AJ, let's go. Boys, let's go. Boys.
The Nazi got counter attack. Hold the fortress.
What? All right. This better be good. Okay.
Open. I'm heading for the palace.
The royal guards counterattacking. We'll be there as soon as we can.
I'm going after Pagan.
Oh my goodness.
Miss me?
What? Miss you? I don't even know you. Holy shit. Thing is, this recording is already on 45 minutes, so I'm gonna have to stop the episode right here. Thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you soon.